here today with Greg Traxson. Greg, welcome to Greenbush.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. Now, I have to have a disclaimer right as we start here. This is a little off of business casual, I think. So, can you tell us, we're having our social studies conference today, and can you tell us just a little bit more about why you're here, and then obviously why you're dressed in period attire?
Well, this is part of my classroom wardrobe. And what I'm doing at Greenbush today is I'm presenting on living history, using living history in the classroom. And, you know, there's a lot of different activities and projects that incorporate themselves into the heading of living history, everything from first-person writings to journals or diaries. But role-playing is definitely a very effective tool. And the older the kids get, the better research they can do. And I guess I would be living proof of that because I take what I have learned and turn it around into characters that I portray in the classroom for the students as well.
It's very interesting. A lot of the talk nowadays, especially amongst technology, is creating an immersive environment where a student or students or a classroom is they're totally immersed in whatever they're studying, whether it's social studies, mathematics, science, whatever. With something like this, I could see where that would be really very easy to achieve because you're part of the learning environment.
Right, and that's the curse of social studies or social sciences is that it's boring.
Right.
You know, the kids, the student, you know, they come into the classroom with this concept that this is going to be boring, and so developing that relationship with history is key. And living history projects, and the students don't start out putting a hat and a coat on,
right.
But over time they get to the point where they want to portray that person that they're studying, and it is. It's a process of immersion.
Yeah, that's very interesting. Well, we're certainly glad that you're here with us today, and I would imagine there's probably some teachers out there or administrators that may want to contact you should they decide to adopt similar practices in their classrooms or in their buildings. How can they get a hold of you, Greg?
Well, I teach at LeBec County High School, and my email address is gtraxson, T-R-A-X-S-O-N, at usd506.k12.ks.us.
Okay. Hey, thanks again for being here today. It's not every day that we have a Civil War soldier right here in the podcast studio.
Thank you. It's great being here.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.